Hello, my name is jahg and welcome to the first in a series about creating Java code. Now the way we're going to do this is we're going to develop plugins for a Minecraft bucket server, and it's going to have a variety of features. It's going to show you pretty much a bit of everything that's involved in doing that particular process, but there are several things we need to get out of the way first. For instance, it's useful, in fact it's more than useful, it's necessary to have a server set up locally, a bucket server set up locally, so that you can test what you created instantly without having to upload it to a server, restart the server remotely, and possibly cause disruption if your plugins don't work. And they won't work. At some point they're going to cause crashes, they're going to cause the whole server to topple over, so having a local server is the most vital component of this whole business. So that's the first thing we're going to do. Now, this particular series is going to be several parts of this, I don't know how many. We're going to cover a ton of bits and pieces, hopefully very shortish videos that are going to hopefully give you a little bit of insight into how to create code, how to use the various features of the Java programming language, how to use the various features of Bukkit within that, how to use the various features of the Java development environment, and all sorts of other bits and pieces. Now this first part is going to update a very brief tutorial I did before about setting up the server locally. So I've got the same shortcuts here about some pages on the interwebs that I'm going to need. So I'm just going to run through this as quickly, possibly, as I can. Now the first thing I need to do is create a new folder to store the server. So I will call it MC Server. That's a suitable name for that. And this is where I'm going to download all my bits and pieces. This is where your world folder files are going to be. Oh, sorry, I should just leave that window there. There we go. The first place we need to do to go to is this place, which is wiki.bukkit.org/setting-up-a-server, and it basically has a step-by-step guide for various different operating systems, including Linux and macOS, which is what I'm using. And Windows is at the top there. It's actually slightly simpler for Windows, so once again, you could follow most of what I'm doing if you're using a Windows system, and then you just use this thing instead of this thing. This thing down here. Right? That's how that's going to be. So I'm just going to follow this through, basically. So this is the first thing that's going to teach you how to go through various steps of starting a server, downloading it, and so on. But I know that I'm going to plunge in and go straight to this website, bukkit.org. So it's not the wiki. And you can download the server that you need from here. It's a Java thing, so it's a jar file that you're going to get. If I click on the latest recommended build, is always the best for starting out, because you're guaranteed that the server is as stable as it's going to get for that particular version. So this supports Minecraft 1.3.1, which also supports 1.3.2 indirectly, because not very many changes existed between the versions of the client, so clients can connect. So I clicked on the latest edition of this. There's this massive green thing here. This will allow me to download this. I'm going to download it directly into this folder I created. So go to the desktop, and somewhere I've got my folder for this. Where is it? MC Server and craftbucket.jar. I guess that's a good enough name. So I'm going to save that. We'll see it pop up here. It's relatively small file, 11 meg in this particular case. It's very much more large than the default vanilla Minecraft server, but it's got a lot more stuff inside it, so it's understandable. It's got to support a lot more things. So there we go, that's finished downloading. And now that that has downloaded, you can't just double click it and run it. Well, you can, but you won't be able to configure it in quite as specific a way as we'll need to. So I'm going to close that and go back to the how to set up a server page. Again, I'll put all these links in the description of this video so you can grab it from there if you need to. Now, I'm running on a Mac system, so I need to obtain the server files. I've done that, download the file, move it into this place, rename it whatever. Well, I've already done that. So now I need to set up a script to run it. Now, the easiest way is to basically create a document with this. It's like a batch file for Windows, but it sets up a certain amount of memory and tells it which name to use for this file, because this file could have different names if you're running a snapshot edition or something, or a debug version. So I'm just going to copy this text and I'm going to plop it into a text edit file, which I'm going to bloop, click on this business. So I need to save this. These figures here are how much memory to set up and then how much to allow in total. So 1 gigabyte, that'll do for now. We might need to tweak that later if you're creating large plugins that do all sorts of snazzy stuff. I'm just going to save this as, if I just reduce this in size a little, it says to save the file, put it inside your folder that you've set up for your server, so it's going to appear here as something.command. That's what we're going to do. So if I do that right now, we should already be in the right, nope, we're roughly in the right place, so that's where I'm going to put it. I don't want it called that, however. So let's just call it launcher. No, that's not how you spell it. Launcher.command. That'll do me. Boop. And there we go. It knows it's a command file. I don't need to edit that anymore, but these numbers are what you'd change if it needs more memory when you run it. Now, the more memory you assign a server, the better it runs, so that's just something to keep in mind. Now, this is not good enough on its own. It's just a text file. I need to convert it into a runnable application. Because if I don't do that, then it's not going to be usable as just a double-click thing. So in order to do this, I've opened the terminal window, which is this business here. It's in utilities somewhere, I think, in the actual menus. I keep it down here because it's something I need often, as well as all of this other business that we'll get to. Well, not all of it. Now, I need to make it runnable, so that's this chmod business here. So I'm just going to grab that, flop that in there, and then basically I need to tell it this is the file to do that with. And if I press enter, I believe I should be done now. It's now made it a proper file that can be run, so I should be able to actually run this now. So if I close this, don't need that at the moment, if I double click this, I should be able to have, oh yes, I do indeed want to run that. It's going to start up the server. We'll see various files being generated here. Lots of errors to start with. Couldn't find this file, couldn't find that file. Well, it's just created all the bits for the first time, so that's not particularly surprising that it should do that. So after it's generated these folders, it's now generating the world, the nether world, and the end. It generates the spawn area for those things. I haven't picked a particular seed, so it's going to be a totally random world. There we go. And we are all done. So there's our server, it's running. I should be able to connect to it, but before you do, just type op and then your username. Otherwise, there might be slight issues with regard to not being able to run certain commands. So we want to make sure that everything runs as an op to start with. So that's that. That actually gets stored in this text file if you wanted to actually edit it manually. But there we go. So the server's up and running. Now I apologize for any lag that might ensue from running this. I use a particular launcher because it allows me to use various different jar files that I've used, kept hold of all these years of working on this. I've already got my username and password in there. And we should be able to connect to this server now. Multiplayer, I want a direct connect for now. And I'm just going to pop in localhost because that will connect to this machine. It's running on the same machine, so that should be good. If I join this server, we should see several things down there at the bottom. It's, oh gosh, there we go. Oh gosh, the world is generating slowly. I apologize for the lag whilst I'm recording, but that's not going to be doing too much in Minecraft specifically in this series. But whilst that generates, we can see that down here it's logged me in. Fair enough. I should be able to do some commands, so I should be able to put myself into game mode 1. There we go, and I'm now in creative, as we can see from this business here. And I'm going to be using this, and I'm going to be using too many items as well, to because I prefer this sometimes to find stuff. But there we go, so we've got our server up and running. So now we should be ready for the next part, which is to create the magic that is a plugin. So I'll see you next time. Goodbye.